I'm Jansandra Mullegama. This is my case study of the Nestle. The story of this Nestle, so I like to say Henry Nestle was fined in 1866 and mother company located in Switzerland. Actually, this is the very critical area. Nestle started the operations, then World War I and World War II. That 447 factories are worldwide, and according to the sustainable development, the Nestle is supporting to the agriculture production worldwide. 10% of the world's coffee production, it's about 10%, and cocoa production is about 10%, and milk they are supporting that sector, contributing by the 2%. Actually, total assets are 137 billion, and net income is 10.46 billion in 2006. And actually, there are over 2,000 items in worldwide they are doing. But actually, all the items are spread via these brands in infant nutrition beverages, cereals, and chocolate confectioneries, Maggies, etc., etc. This is a typical supply chain: farmer, supplier, and producer, the stores with refrigerators and distributors, and finally they reach to the clients. Next slide, we can see this is the general situation toward the forward, but actually these significant things, the information flowing is coming to the back. The information flowing is go to the my knowledge. Information is education. Education means technical sites and quality policies and quality controls. These positions flowing with the contributing for the parts of the supply chain of the Nestle. The sourcing, there are four steps. Sourcing means very critical things. And the first one is traceable target, and next one is transferable actual and level of traceability, and next one is reasonability sources actual. Finally, they decide their sales according to the actual price, and this one is cash flow and backward integrations and forward integrations. These are very important things. The manufacturer is responsible for the global logistics, because the goods are perishable, and this should be kept a long time. So therefore, actually, according to the manufacturer, that global logistics decide that items what is the place, and this is the distribution. Integrates with the consumer feeds the information flow. The manager decide this availability. This is the position of the last before the consumer. So consumer is always expecting the good quality production according to the distribution. So distribution should be well organized before the consumer. Actually, consumer has the right to use the good quality product that was regulated by the Nestle through the materials, preparations, processing, testing, packaging, and transportation, and the science behind the safety, etc., etc. Then inventory has taken down the 45% of the raw material since the 1998 in USA. Other one is to bring it down the logistic cost, double handling and warehousing. And they are inventory using in the cloud technology. Cloud technology means very huge and a huge advantage throughout the world. So this supply chain has the distinctive integration, vertical integration, horizontal integration, green integration. These are conducted by the conducted according to the logistic process. So therefore, this integration is supporting and nourish the supply chain of the Nestle. The vertical integration is significant. There are significant integration. They are using this one, scarcity of the natural resources. The scarcity of the natural resources. Other example is African supplier. African supplier pays for the EU disaster. So they are factory Nestle supply chain supposed to increase the brand name and value, brand name value and suppliers revenue by this supply chain. And then coordination can be increased. And after that, they are supporting the market share increase and market share increase. And decreasing the cost, so therefore actually automatically competitiveness is available. So via this process control, they have achieved the sustainable development according to the United Nations. And this is the general flow chart of the raw material to after sale, and not only Nestle but also all the companies are using this one. And current transformation of the vertical integration decides the backward integrations and forward integrations acting as a turning point. And this is not the Nestle but also several different companies are here in this slide. And this one, I like to get this example. Right, next one. Right, this orange color boxes. This orange color boxes are saying the scientific integrations to scientific partnership to the supply chain of the Nestle. So actually, first one quality, and sometime second. One is they are doing the bacterial testing, and horizontal they are spreading like spreading two kind of way, merger and acquisition. Actually this horizontal supply chain is work as a merger, so it can be the multinational company throughout the world, and geographical level ownership and trade name. Relevant company can be promote their brand names or trade names in out of land. So that is the advantage. And so when we go other side, when we go other countries, we can find we can profile in the consumer event. So therefore actually, so when they are profiling other consumers, so it is the huge advantage green making the green community. And green community. So therefore, where other advantage is productive diversity made by the diversity of the resources. So there is another thing. And forward integrations and backward integration. Forward integration is acquiring the ownership of the distributor, and backward ownership is acquiring of the supplier. This both together make the well balanced. That is being called balance integrations. So therefore, balance integration should be in the supply chain. Sustainable development. This is a very critical caption in the world. Sustainable forecasting made the sustainable community. Sustainable sourcing then in the supply chain. Sustainable sourcing then. Sustainable distribution. Balance the sustainable manufacturing and sustainable consuming. There's a organizational risk in this one, right? So how to confirm achieved cost flowing from the supply chain is very difficult. And actually other one is logistics supply throughout the world. It is very difficult and huge task, and management supervision. So Nestle SA is in New Zealand, but all over the world, management supervision should be spread out. And next one is sustainability support via the Nestle supply chain. Multi-stakeholder development means businessmen and voluntary service and social workers. So are the that's in the betterment of there. Right. The next one is farm animal welfare have been taken over by Nestle, and sustainable sources of the Coca-Cola in Ghana and Ivory Coast. And actually, another one is Nestle water policy have been launched in 2000, and 15 million of children is are looked after by the by Nestle. Other one is improving of the 30 million livelihood worldwide. This slide says the sustainability errors. Example is baby formula adding with the polluted water is a huge allegations to the supply chain of the Nestle. And another one, there is allegations greenwashing also. It is very huge disadvantage of the disadvantage for the Nestle supply chain. And between 12 and 15 children are used for the as a child slave labor. So actually, that is a famous expression, the dark side of the chocolate. And foodborne bacteria found out in 2009 that America said that this is a warning for the consumer. And 15 breakfast have the highest level of sugar, so they have actually, so we want to find out these are the advantage and disadvantage of the supply chain of the Nestle. Thank you.
Thank you, Hira, for your presentation. And you have covered a few areas, conceptually in supply chain, from sourcing to manufacturing, and then in the integration. Just tell us how Nestle has used horizontal approach in the integration.
I want to say that actually Nestle in 1861, so that era when Henry Nestle found out that company is the result of the pre-module of the horizontal integration. Nowadays actually they develop the horizontal integration in very sophisticated way. So at the moment they have operating in all the continental, and 447 plants are located in everywhere. This horizontal supply chain has the distinctive identification. What is that? Acting as a merger and acting as an acquisition side, right? Merger is finding out the other resources, finding out other workforces, and find out many things. And acquisition being find out the geographical area with the relevant resources. So therefore, I think the most of multinational companies are using this method as a acquiring other geographical level out of the mother company located.